As a New York City high school English teacher, Adrian Antao has embraced technology to support his students. While some express concern about the influence of AI on education, Antao has worked with educators, coders, and designers to develop an AI tool that helps students with their writing revisions. He shares his brief but spectacular take on harnessing AI in schools.
Here it is, the argument essay. It's a yes-no question that needs an answer in the intro.
Because I've taught for close to 20 years, I've taught almost every English class the school has offered.
Why did the author want to write these four paragraphs?
I've wanted to be a teacher since I was 10 years old. Initially, I thought it was a job that would garner you respect as an adult. As I got older, I fell in love with literature and have lucked into a dream job. OpenAI dropped ChatGPT on all of us last November. My initial reaction was terror. The summer began with me sitting in on conversations about how to adapt AI for the classroom. And by July, we began a partnership with a company called Playlab that provided an open platform for teachers to create their own AI bot. I'm going on to Project Toni. It's an AI chatbot that can be a teaching assistant for teachers and a writing tutor for students. So I'm going to put in the assignment. It is designed to read articles that students are also reading so they can engage in the conversation to begin the revision process. Toni will provide strengths and areas for improvement for each paragraph. The problem that I had in mind was largely the jealousy I felt toward math teachers and science teachers who can give instant feedback to students during tutoring. If I assign a 5-page essay, that's a 500-page novel that I would have to get through. Before Toni existed, the feedback cycle largely mimicked the letter writing that you would see in Jane Austen movies, roughly 2 to 3 weeks, and this shrinks that feedback cycle to 24 to 72 hours.
Remember what I told you on Tuesday.
Introducing Project Toni into the classroom has been fascinating. What I'm discovering is that I'm needing to teach them how to use it well. Just press 1, and Toni will give paragraph by paragraph suggestions. It's not Alexa or Google. You don't just give it simple commands. You have to engage with it. Specifically, could you elaborate on why this was a poor example? And it will give you 2 to 3 sentences of explanation. And you can convince Toni that it was incorrect. But what that takes is for you to make a stand for your own writing, which is such a huge move in a writer's psychology to have the confidence in your own sentences, where often students are coming from a space of doubt and fear. You're entering in a partnership the way a professional writer and a professional editor enters into a conversation, and they're both engaged in trying to make the writing better.
The P is the purpose.
One of the goals of being a good teacher is to give them academic attention and show them how intelligent they are. What I enjoy most about teaching writing is seeing growth in one of my students. It fills me up the way a great sentence in a novel fills me up. It's a really fulfilling experience. My name is Adrian Antao, and this is my brief but spectacular take on harnessing AI in schools.
Tonight's Brief But Spectacular is part of a 6-part collection on the future of education.
And you can watch the entire series on our website. That's pbs.org/newshour.